technically we are 25 years into the 21st century. 2024 is 25 years. We have cleared a quarter century, and we are embracing technology for everything. And you're out there networking and hustling like crazy. So when you meet me, give me your business card. I get it. While it is the 21st century and everybody's using social media and other platforms to communicate and connect, there is nothing more professional and cooler than the business card. So while we need to embrace technology, and we certainly are, and we need to use all of it to get the word out there about our small businesses, our side hustle, our freelance gig, whatever it is you're doing, you still have to embrace the old school methods because they work. So when I meet you at a networking event, you sly hustler, I want your business card. So stick around. I'm going to give you three tips on why you need business cards and how to use them effectively.
Will we be getting business cards?
Here comes the... If you met me, I'm walking up to you. I have my business card at the ready. I have business cards at the ready at all times at a networking event.
Permit me to introduce myself. My name is Coyote. Wile E. Coyote. Genius.
And the first thing in my hand is a business card. I'm there to hustle. I'm there to talk to you. Maybe I can't talk to you. I gotta move on. I'm not judging anybody. Fantastic if you're using technology. But what you want to be doing is having a business card. And here's why you need these. You might think it's antiquated, you might think it's bullshit, but it's not. Trust me, business cards have been used forever, and with technology being what they are, they can be amazing pieces of marketing material that can help you garner more attention than getting lost in the Instagram feed. So tip number one, what happens when technology fails, or when the person operating the technology can't operate it?
Back here. Dude, that makes sense. Wait.
Yeah. Listen, most phones today have QR readers built into the camera. They have NFC already on, but on some of the older phones, they do not. And on some phones, people turn off their NFC. So having one of these NFC reader business cards, may not always work when you want to tap it against the phone, because the person may not have it connected. Or if you're using QR code, this may not work either. Maybe they have a phone that the QR isn't on already. Business card is absolutely the must, because you are giving a person an opportunity to have your information in their hand, in their pocket, in their wallet. It is going to be something physical. Tip number two, time. If you're in a situation where you have to get to a workshop, or the person that you're trying to communicate with is busy, the business card is a quick slide through. You get right in there and you give that business card, that handoff, right to them. And this way, if you can't talk to them, you at least have a door opener to call them. So here's what you do. This is the technique in using it. When you're pressed for time, or if you're someone who doesn't want to rudely interrupt, your business card comes out, it's at the ready, and it's a slide in. And at a networking event, everybody realizes we're here to network, so you're not necessarily being rude when you briefly interrupt a conversation with someone you want to speak to, and you say, excuse me, you're in a conversation, I just want to give you my business card, can I have yours? Most of the time you'll get it, and they'll just move back into their conversation. And it's that simple. Now you have their card, they have your card, you call them. This is when your NFC technology and your QR code technology isn't going to work. When you need to do that interruption, when time is of the essence. So slide in, hand the card, ask for the card, slide out. That's how well a business card can work for you. Tip number three, good reason to have a business card, it is an inexpensive leave behind. Now, if you've never heard that term, leave behind, that's where there are things at events like brochures, flyers or one sheets, postcards that companies or people leave somewhere. So having an inexpensive, easy to carry leave behind is a great use for a business card. It's not a brochure, it's not a big bulky postcard, maybe it's not as profound and decorative and informational as a postcard.
Is that a gram? New card. What do you think?
Whoa, very nice.
Or as a brochure, but nonetheless, it's something you can leave behind, and it's an inexpensive piece of marketing material. Here's the how-to on that. let's say you're at a workshop event where there's a bunch of classes going on all day. One of the first things you can do is you can walk into that classroom and you can put a business card down in front of every chair. First one in, last one out. People leave, you go back and you pick up your business cards that nobody took, you move on to the next class. It is a perfect leave behind. It's also a great leave behind if you're at a networking event and there is a table where people can put their business cards. As a piece of marketing material, it has equal power to any other marketing material. It may even have more power because it fits into the pocket of the person picking it up. A lot easier than a postcard or a brochure. So, as a leave behind, it's a great marketing asset. Reason number one, when technology fails or the person operating the technology fails. So number two, time. Time, it's a great time saver, it's a great icebreaker, it's a great tool to insert yourself into a conversation or make a connection, ask for a business card, and move along to your next person or your next event. And it allows you to make that call back quite easily from the comfort of your own home. What happens when somebody doesn't have the time to search you out on LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, or wherever else you're sending them? Tip number three is leave behind marketing material. It is not something you keep in your pocket. So listen, folks. Business cards are inexpensive. You can go to websites. You can go to your local printer. There are so many places to get an inexpensive set of business cards. You can even go as far as to pick up an Avery label template and print your own business cards at home. Just have them. So the last tip with business cards, because of technology's come so far and made business cards such an inexpensive product, inexpensive piece of marketing material, you can come up with almost any kind of concept.
That is really nice.
Eggshell with Romalian type. What do you think?
Nice.
So for example, making a business card that is memorable and unique is a great conversation starter. We tend to like the square business cards because it fits with our branding. One of the things we do that's unique about our business cards is the backs of our business cards are different for each business associate, while the branding on the other side is always the same.
Impressive. Very nice. Mm.
And we've tried different things. We've tried pearlescence. We've tried super triple thick cards. We've tried a lot of different sort of materials to see which gets the best reaction. And so far, these soft touch cards, people really like the feel of these. Make a unique business card if you can. I met a woman who handed me a die cut, triple die cut business card. It was literally layers of die cut that had a texture to make the feeling of a flower. It's a great conversational piece. And that's how you become memorable with a business card. So whatever it's going to be, whether you're using it as an icebreaker or a piece of marketing material, leave behind, make a unique business card if you can, or at least just make a business card. Have one. This is a tool that's been around for, I don't know how long, it's got to be, you know, easily 100 years, if not more, but use a business card. Always have a business card ready when you're about to go speak to somebody. And if anybody knows me out there, they know it's the first thing I'm handing them when I'm walking up to them. So go out there and make some shit happen.